Hi! Earlier, I built a beam dump for my laser beams. I think it works well, but I have never used a professional model, so how would I know if my homemade one is any good? In this video, I'll test it against a $200 pro model. Will my DIY model fail miserably in the comparison? In any case, I will try to improve it by 3D printing a custom piece to give it a variable aperture. I'll even open up the pro model for a look inside. Always, as in always, wear laser safety glasses for the right wavelengths when using powerful lasers. A beam dump is not an excuse for not wearing safety glasses. First off, what's the point of a laser beam dump? As many commented on the build video, I can just turn off the laser if I don't want the laser dot. True, but sometimes you only want the laser beam without the strong laser dot burning away its target and overshining everything with dangerous levels of light. For example, in an earlier video where I was interested in the beam reflecting off a neutral density filter, the beam dump safely terminated the main beam, keeping it from interfering with the measurement or burning my wall. Or in the video where I wanted to compare the beam profiles on some very strong laser engraver modules, without the laser dot overshining the beam, washing everything out in camera. A beam dump is simply an easy and safe way of terminating a laser beam, and building your own is not that hard. But can it match the performance of a model for professional lab use? Let's find out. For a start, I'll simply circle the beam from a handheld laser around in both apertures. Which one absorbs the laser light the best? Interesting. The reflections coming from inside the Pro model are sometimes strong enough to overexpose the camera, making the green light appear white. Other times, when the internal reflection is pointing away from the camera, only a little reflection from the aperture sidewall is visible. On the home build, there is a more consistent, weak reflection coming from the inside, but never enough to overexpose the camera. I can't tell which is better from this alone. Time for a more technical test with a steady beam and a lux meter measuring the intensity of the reflected light. And with three different laser colors across the visible spectrum. First up, a whopping 700 milliwatts red from this small laser. Okay, it is close. Only a single lux or so in difference, and lowest from the home build. Seen from another angle, we can tell there is a lot of spillage from this laser, that the front of the home build scatters better than the Pro model. I don't see any reflections from the inside as well, unlike on the Pro model. I think my home build one wins this round. Now for the 450 milliwatts green Hercules. Huh, this time the Pro model measures a lux lower. Looking closer at the footage, it seems like the internal reflection from the Pro model is sent downwards, away from the lux meter, while it is more consistently scattered all around from the home build. But seen from the lux meter's angle, the Pro wins this round. Alright. The third and strongest laser will decide it then. A 1500 milliwatts indigo blue laser. Fingers crossed it will not burn out pixels in my camera. For a decisive third test, this is annoyingly undecisive. No clear winner. To my eyes, the reflections from the Pro model look stronger, but the lux meter didn't see it, and I may be biased towards my own creation. What I can say for sure is that they are close. The home build does not fail miserably in a comparison with a Pro model. Nice. Before I open up the Pro model, I'll attempt to make the DIY model even better by mounting a variable aperture instead of the fixed 10mm aperture I've had on both models until now. I just need to figure out how to mount it. Luckily, 3D printing at home in high quality is a possibility, especially with a UV resin printer like this one from AnyCubic. And with a wash and cure machine, the post-processing is way more convenient than the cat litter scoop I used for my first 3D print. Here's how the print went. Thanks to my brother for making the 3D model in Blender. Not bad. Looks good for a first try, but will the aperture fit? Uh-oh. That feels tighter than I was aiming for. A little too tight. Being a total noob, I may have scaled the prints a millimeter too small. But you know what? It works. I'm pleased with this result from the first run with the first model of my own design that even needs to have the right size. How could I have made this without a 3D printer? Now that I have a variable aperture on the front of the beam dump, I can match it to the beam diameter, capturing even more light inside the beam dump. For example, if the laser has massive spillage. Or if the beam has diverged into a larger diameter. More info on divergence in an earlier video of mine. The variable aperture adds a lot of cost to the homebuilt model, but it is still way cheaper than the Pro model, and I'd say the homebuilt is now the better performer. After a short message, I'll open up the Pro model. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. You helped me buy the Lux Meter and Pro Beam Dump, making this video possible. For just $1 a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link in the description. Thank you. Okay, let's see what's inside it. Or maybe not. Did they use red threadlocker to keep me out? Hang on. Oh yeah, there we go. Aha, it works on the same principle as the home build. A cone is used to scatter the light around the inside. If you want to see what's inside the home build, I'll put links in all the usual places to my build video. One difference is the grooves on the inner walls of the Pro model. I guess they are meant to cause even more scatter, but they are surprisingly shiny. I was expecting a more matte black finish. The walls are also much thicker than on my home build, good for absorbing heat. Though my home build has more than twice as much thermal mass. The tip of the cone looks pointier than I remember from the home build one. Here's a match for scale. Nice detail with very little retro reflection of the laser beam from the cone apex. Alright, hope you liked this video enough to click like and maybe even subscribe for more like it. For more on a similar subject, I recommend watching the video where I test viewer suggestions for lowering the power of a laser beam, including cola. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.